within the past year, there's been an explosion of information to understand how Zika virus causes particular types of disease in fetuses and newborns, as well as in adults and in pregnant women. Most of the sexual transmission is occurring male to female and male to male. And so knowing this, and knowing that you can detect virus in sperm and semen for long periods of time, leads to the hypothesis that the virus is persisting for a long time in the testes or in other organs of the male reproductive tract. So we wanted to know, not just was it persisting, but what is the consequence of that persistence?
We did a longitudinal study where we infected the male mice with the Zika virus. And what we found was by day 7, you could already detect the virus there, and it was cleared by around day 21. But you could see a progressive destruction of the cells in the testes. So by day 21, basically the entire testes was about the tenth of the size of what it originally was. And as a result, there was no sperm. There was some detectable virus that was left, but again, it was cleared from the serum. So even though the virus was gone, the destruction was done. We also mated those mice over 4 cycles and found a decreased number of live births in the infected males.
The key implication is what happens in humans. We know that in humans, you can get persistent infection for months. What we don't know is, does it also cause the same level of injury or not? And is it true for people who've had apparent infections, as well as ones who may be having infections but maybe didn't have many symptoms at all? In other words, does the degree of severity of infection correlate with injury or not? So we don't know. So those things need to be followed in human trials.